Guys Palace.
Frozen Ever After.
That was so fun! I saw Olaf. Olaf is so cute! The animation in Elsa and Anna's face is amazing. I thought it was real.
Yeah, I don't know how they did that. Maybe some sort of projection or something.
Almost
looks like realistic.
Amazing. No wonder they have long lines.
Yeah, the fast lane, or sorry, the regular lane right now is 60 minutes wait. Good thing we have fast passes. This is the Mexico Pavilion.
So nice. Really being Coco.
You're like in Mexico.
Is this Coco's village, the one in the movie? It's a good segue away from the heat outside.
Yeah, there's different Coco merch. Mugs, all that stuff.
That's because hat looks too small for me.
It was okay. It was a shorter ride.
I find it kind of boring, or maybe just because we went to Frozen first, so our expectation is so high.
The bar was really high at Frozen.
And then in the Tres Amigos, it's just
Three Caballeros.
There's no animation that much, just more on the screen.
And there's like a few animatronics, but there's a give and take because it's a shorter line.
The line is very fast.
Yeah, the line's very fast. It takes about just 20 minutes just to get up.
Because the boat is just continuously rotating each time. I think the ride is for kids.
But if you're here, still have a look.
And if you want to avoid the sun outside, the heat outside, you can try it out.
Looks like China is one of the bigger pavilions, eh?
I feel like I'm in China.
Yeah, I think they have restaurants, they have shops, they have like a whole show dedicated to China and some galleries about Shanghai, China.
They have lots of temples. Let's check it out.
The bridge is up!
Bridge is down!
Yay, we can pass! We can go to Germany now.
Let's go to Germany.
This is where all the equipment for the show later tonight is coming, so they needed a way to get in. This is Germany.
frosted caramel cream.
Let's see what Germany offers. Snacks. Oh, so nice in here. So I guess each pavilion has their own country ears. This is the Italian pavilion.
We're in Italy.
You gotta hold your hand like this. Here, here. Italian pavilion. They have a great, looks like a plaza here. You gotta do this first. Pizzeria! We haven't had lunch, so we're gonna try to get a table here. We don't have reservations too. Hopefully it's not busy.
What time is it?
It is 5:15.
Hungry face. Thank you, Italy. You made us so full.
The food was amazing.
It's so good. Do not order when you're hungry. You'll overorder.
What's the next pavilion? I think it's American, no?
America. We have this tradition wherein we collect magnets from the places where we go. And now, we are in Epcot, Disneyland. We are in search to look for a red magnet for our collection. The White Palace.
White Palace? White House. You would think that the US would have the biggest pavilion, but I don't think so, because China is definitely bigger and Japan is definitely bigger. Just look at this.
Are we still in Florida? I feel like we are in Japan.
That's why they have such a big pavilion, because there's a big shop inside. You can see all things Japan, including like their culture, modern Japan, even their marketplace, like all the food that you can find in Japan, you can find it here.
There's also a small museum where you can see Japanese culture and their fashion. On to the next pavilion.
You can almost feel the heat actually. Because it's so humid today. Moroccan weather. We tried our best to go around and look for all the details and stuff for all the pavilions, but one day is not enough.
It feels like we went around the world.
Yeah, we should have been nice, yeah.
We also learned a lot about other countries, like their culture, their food, their music, and their fashion, almost everything, right?
Yeah, which is pretty nice. If you wanted to, like, instead of like going to other countries and stuff, if you want to just experience the culture and the food, this is the place to be. So tomorrow we're gonna be in Animal Kingdom together with the rest of the family.
Don't forget to like and subscribe. See you in our next vlog.
Bye.